I remember when I got the newsflash about hair color, that aha, that light bulb moment, and it was when I was lightening hair and I realized that to get neutral, I needed to use ash. And once I realized that, the color wheel, the principles all made sense, but I was like, ah!
You need to know that you can never have 100% predictable results if you're breaking a rule. It's always very important to follow the principles and to follow manufacturer's directions.
Never break the rules. You can break the rules, but you better know the rules first.
The principles when it comes to hair color are extremely important because they truly help to set us up for success and they guarantee predictability with our hair color.
Principles of hair color is going to really have a huge impact on our industry. Every hairdresser out there is searching for knowledge, searching for, you know, the answers to make them successful and to really help their clients. So I think this is going to be a major tool in making that happen.
What we'll talk about now are the principles of color. The definition of color is the phenomenon of light and visual perception. Color is a complex, fascinating, and beautiful medium of creative expression that can be explained scientifically. In this episode, we'll be covering the types of pigment we use and how light affects them. Additionally, we'll discuss the laws of color, what can and cannot be done with color, and most importantly, the tool we use, the color wheel.
Let's start with light. Scientist Isaac Newton tells us that white light is made up of all the colors in the spectrum. You can see this effect when a light hits a prism. When white light hits a surface, it is reflected, absorbed, transmitted, and/or a combination of these. Let's take blue as an example. If blue is the only color reflected off the surface, the eye sees blue. Every other color is absorbed. How that relates to hair color is light will travel through the cuticle layer and bounce off what we know as pigment. When light hits pigment, whether it's artificial or natural, all the colors are absorbed, reflected, and/or transmitted through that strand of hair. With hair texture, whether straight, wavy, or curly, also comes into play when we perceive the color of hair. If the surface is flat, it will reflect a lot more. If there are lots of highs and lows, the light will reflect more in some areas than others. You'll see more light reflecting from straight hair than curly hair. This is why it's so easy to create shine in straight hair. It's more difficult to make curly hair or wavy hair look shiny. It's important to take that into consideration and adjust your formula depending on the texture of hair so that you have the right amount of light reflection you want in a color. There are several terms or characteristics used to describe color. Artists who paint or designers who work with different fabrics and colors also use these terms. First is hue, or the name of the color, blue, red, yellow, and so forth. The second characteristic is the saturation, or the amount of hue that's in the color. For instance, we have a piece of paper that's powder blue and another that's navy blue. The saturation from the paper that's navy blue is much higher, even though we are looking at the same hue. The third characteristic of color is tone. This describes the amount of light value in a color. So the more light value we see, the lighter and brighter the color will appear to be. The spectrum of light is made up of three colors, the primary colors, blue, red, and yellow. All the other colors are made up from combinations of these colors. Blue is the most dominant, red is the second most dominant, and yellow is the third most dominant. This is important to understand when we're formulating. It will give us an idea of how strong one color can be in a formula. If we want to create a balanced mixture of these colors, we need to know which primary is the most dominant. The law of color states that combinations of these three primary colors create all the colors in the spectrum. When you mix two primary colors in equal proportions, you get what we call a secondary color. For example, if you mix blue and red together, you get violet. Violet is a secondary color. There are two other secondary colors. If you mix red and yellow, you get orange. If you mix blue and yellow, you get green. You always get the same result from the same combination. This is a principle of color. If you mix a primary color and a neighboring secondary color in equal proportions, you get what we call a tertiary color. As an example, if you mix red, a primary, with a violet, a secondary, you get red-violet, a tertiary color. The six tertiary colors are yellow-orange, red-orange, red-violet, blue-violet, blue-green, and yellow-green. So again, you can see that the law of color says that all color is made up of these three primary colors and combinations of them. We have a tool that we use called the color wheel, which visually displays the law of color. It's a universal tool used by hair colorists, painters, and other artists who work with color. As you can see, primary, secondary, and tertiary colors are arranged on the wheel. Complementary colors are also identified. These are colors which neutralize each other or refine each other, resulting in a neutral shade of brown, blonde, or gray. For example, if we have a color that's too warm, we add a cool tone, it will neutralize it. For example, let's take the primary color red. If you add green, which is directly across the color wheel, you'll balance them. The more green you add, the cooler it will become. These are complementary colors. Every warm color has a cooler, complementary color. The color wheel is further divided into warm and cool colors. The colors that are predominantly blue are cool-toned colors. Blue is the darkest and coolest primary. When it's combined with any other color, it's a stronger shade and results in a darker color with a cool tone. Colors that are primarily red or yellow are warm-toned colors. When red is added to the mixture, the result is a warmer tone. Yellow is the lightest of the primary colors, and when mixed with other colors, results in a lighter and brighter effect. So how do we use the color wheel to formulate hair color? We can mix compatible shades, personalize formulas, or avoid unwanted tones. For example, suppose a client with medium brown hair is interested in going lighter and doesn't want any red tones. To counteract the naturally occurring unwanted red undertones, you could select a corrective base with a tonal value opposite the unwanted undertone on the color wheel. In this example, green is opposite red. Remember, opposites on the color wheel neutralize.